A visit to the National Weather Service with Sally Salmon and Larry Chicken, Star Forecaster. Our hero Larry is a meteorologist who forecasts the weather. In his spare time, he likes to watch clouds and look for shapes in the clouds. His sidekick Sally is a hydrologist who forecasts how rivers will behave. In her spare time, she likes to go swimming.
It's early morning and Larry's alarm goes off. It's time to get up and head in to work. Larry likes his job because he just loves the weather. He always takes a look at the sky as he heads inside to his job at the National Weather Service. As Larry goes inside, he is already thinking about the weather. But first, he puts his lunch away. It could be a long day of forecasting. Larry collects data about current weather in the area, even in the early morning hours before the sun comes up. The first thing Larry needs to measure is how much rain has fallen in the past few hours. When it snows, he also measures how much snow has fallen. Larry can't resist having a little fun and making a snow angel. Hey, who threw that snowball? While he's outside, Larry takes a look at the clouds, noting how high they are and how much of the sky they cover. Today it looks like the clouds are covering the entire sky. When he comes inside, he compares the clouds he saw with a cloud chart, which helps him figure out what kind of clouds they are. Thermometers tell him the temperature, which measures how warm or cold it is. Automated weather observing systems measure a lot more about the weather, like air pressure, how much moisture is in the air, and how strong the wind is. Larry sure appreciates not having to stand outside all day to keep an eye on the weather. Sometimes Larry helps launch a weather balloon. The balloon holds a little box of instruments that measure the weather up in the air. When they let go of the balloon, it takes the instruments way, way up in the air. Next, Larry heads over to a computer workstation, where he looks at the data collected from the balloon. It tells him how warm or cold, wet or dry, and how windy it is high above the ground. When he is forecasting, Larry spends a lot of time looking at a computer. Satellite pictures help Larry see where the clouds and moisture are. Radar pictures help him to see where it is raining and snowing. Analyzing a map helps Larry to see patterns in the weather. It's a bit like playing connect the dots. By drawing lines that connect places with the same pressure, Larry can find areas of high pressure, which he marks with a blue H, and lows, which he marks with a red L. It also helps him find fronts, which divide cold air from warm air, and are often areas where the weather is the most interesting. Computer models help Larry to see what the weather maps might look like in the next few days. There's a lot of stuff for him to look at. Larry doesn't work alone. He likes to discuss his thoughts with other forecasters and see what they think. Now it's time for Larry to make his forecast.
Sally keeps track of the local rivers. This is especially important when flooding is possible. Sally looks over the river forecasts that come from the River Forecast Center. She needs to figure out how much water will be in the rivers and how long it will take to move downriver. Sally makes adjustments to ensure the forecasts fit with the observations. She feels happy when she makes a good forecast.
An important part about making a good forecast is letting other people know about it. Sometimes Larry talks with folks on the phone. Sometimes he needs to tell local officials like the police about dangerous weather approaching. And sometimes Larry goes on TV to help spread an important weather forecast. The National Weather Service also operates special radio stations that broadcast all weather all the time.
Lots of other people help Larry get his job done and keep the office running. This includes his good friend Pedro Pollo, who keeps all the weather equipment and computers working their best. Others in the office help keep Larry and the rest of the forecasters up to date with the latest forecasting techniques. And help keep up with administrative tasks. And help keep in touch with customers of weather information. All these people help make sure Larry has everything he needs to do his job, which is good because Larry really doesn't like paperwork. He'd rather be forecasting. So, hopefully, if you pay attention to the weather forecast, the weather won't surprise you.
Thanks for visiting the National Weather Service.